Viewer discretion is advised.
She was the first wife of Adam, I think, and she was in like these really ancient texts, but she wasn't in the Bible, and she refused to be below him, like in both ways, I mean, mentally and physically. And she was really cool.
I was talking to a girlfriend of mine about trying to come up with a good name for the concept of the festival, and the first thing she said was Lilith. And I didn't even know the story behind Lilith, and so she explained it to me, and I thought she was an amazing feminist figure, and I was really kind of frustrated that I hadn't heard of her, and very few people who I talked to later had heard of her either, so I felt very happy to be able to reinstate her in her rightful goddess position.
Yeah, this is a question for Sarah. Since you've already kind of announced that this is going to be the last Lilith.
How do they feel about this being the last Lilith fair?
Why is this the last Lilith?
Why are you not going to continue with this?
If you have a daughter, what's the chances you're going to name her Lilith?
Have you been approached by people about buying the name, continuing the tour?
How can you give this up? Why is this lost? Do you give this up?
How do you want people to remember the Lilith fair?
Okay, no need to be nervous. We're all professionals here.
It will
before. All right. Cause you're working, building a mystery. Hold it on and holding it in. Yeah, you're working, building a mystery. And choosing so carefully.
The idea for Lilith originally came from the fact that I wanted to do some shows, but not by myself. I wanted to have the support of some other artists, and in particular some female artists that I had a lot of admiration for. A lot of promoters and a lot of people in general had a big problem with it. They said it couldn't be done. There was a real old school attitude that prevailed in the industry that two women can't play in the same bill together. In the same way, two women couldn't be played back to back on the radio. I guess I really wanted to try and change that. I wanted to try and break that attitude down and try and show that it's not just about women, it's about music. And if it's good music, it should prevail.
Yeah, you're working, building a mystery, and choosing so carefully.
All right. Let's have an awesome
Hang
show.
Hang on, we got a problem with the keyboard.
All right, ready to rock.
Boy. Ready to roll.
Are we going right on today? Everybody up on the side?
Oh, my God, we're doing a show.
Get ready when you're on. When you're ready.
What a beautiful sight. Welcome to Lilith Fair 1999. Welcome on the road with us. We got so many damn tour buses back there, I'm sure we could fit most of them. Take it on the road, what do you think?
Best thing you ever done for me is to help me take my life less seriously. You know, it's only life after all. Yeah. I went to the doctor. I went to the mountains. I looked to the children. I drank from the fountains. Yeah, well, there's more than one answer to these questions. Paul.
wanted me in a crocodile. Unless I seek my source for some affinity.
Like a hootenanny band, you know, from the South. And ever since we started out, we always loved inviting other local musicians to jam with us, and it just makes it more fun to share it, you know. And Lilith was the perfect opportunity for that. So, a traveling roadshow, musicians you could share with.
With a headache like my head against the board, twice as cloudy as I'd been the night before, and I went in seeking clarity.
I went to the doctor, and I went to the mountains.
I just think it's wonderful that I get to be here today and see this wonderful celebration of women in music.
It totally supports women, and that's cool because, you know, sorry guys, but women are moving on up in this world.
I hate saying girl power, but that's what it is. It's like women don't want to help other women a lot, and to see Sarah come out and do this with a lot of women artists is like something else.
Basically, Lilith is a full day of diverse music. We have 11 acts every single day on three separate stages. The music never overlaps. One stage starts, the other one finishes. We have a huge village with a lot of artists selling their wares, jewelry, art. There's a lot of nonprofit organizations who are pamphleting and giving out a lot of information, as well as our corporate sponsors who are also linked to the nonprofits. So it's a great, fun day under the sun and under the stars.
Feeling fine.
your own thing.
There's a charitable thing on a number of different levels. One of them is a dollar from every ticket sale in every city goes to a local shelter. And then there's a lot of money given on a corporate level because, of course, we have to have corporate sponsors to make things run because it's a big thing to put together. So, but the cool thing is we can make them give a lot of money to charity.
It's not a habit, it's cool.
Have obviously established artists who can sell the tickets to bring everybody out to the concerts. We really want to try and develop younger artists and artists who are just starting out, some of which aren't even signed. I mean, last year we had two artists who were unsigned at the beginning of the tour, were signed at the end, so I feel really good about that.
I'll have faith. If you want to turn me on, I'll let your baby turn me on. Don't stop until I say so. Don't stop.
Well, one of the great things about how well organized this tour is and how much it nurtures relationships is that you do get to know people backstage, you get to see what they do, and one of the great thrills is getting to sing with people that you're a fan of.
You know, it just made sense that there were so many amazing artists there within your grasp that were ready and willing to do stuff with you. It's like, well, let's find a song that we can all do together. I mean, it's something that was fairly universal, that a lot of people knew, that had a positive message to it, that had a lot of verses and choruses, so that it would give a number of artists the opportunity to sing a single part, but also a good kind of sing-along chorus that everybody could sing along with as well.
What is my part?
A little love.
Go to fellow man, lend a helping hand, put a little love in your heart.
I just don't know how much more of these little wayfish alternative singers I can take. The Alanis Morissette, Fiona Apple S, we're wandering around naked, we're lost, we're lonely, we're fucked up, we're rich, we're famous, we don't know where we're headed. Honey, just try stepping out of that dirty bathtub for starters and working your way forward from there, okay?
The common criticisms that are made of the Lilith Fair are the artists on Lilith have almost entirely been a certain kind of singer-songwriter, somewhat folkish, progressive in their politics, soft and pretty in their looks, and white, mostly.
I can see it in your eyes. You want to get down with Queen Lace Latifah. I can see your eyes on my body parts. Friendship is slipping, because it ain't me you're hitting. Why you tripping, switching? You can get a taste from the black queen that captivates the mass when I slide on the scene.
There's not enough ethnicity in this tour, maybe. There's not enough flavor, just different things necessarily, but
if you go out and look at the audience, it's probably targeted more towards the type of music that Sheryl Crow does or Sarah McLachlan does. There's nothing to bitch about, though. If you got a problem, put out another tour. That's my feeling on it.
All the ladies in the place, so how it go when you show a little kindness? Cats wanna or some old neck shit, some old sex. When you call up from the door, it's strictly friendship.
A national group called Feminists for Life, you know, are angered at Lilith Fair because they believe that their refusal of getting a booth at the Lilith Fair Village because they take a pro-life stance is hypocritical against the inclusive pro-woman attitude they feel Lilith Fair should invoke. So I wanted to get your comments on that.
Well, this is my festival, so I can do what I want.
Mm-hmm.
No, I mean, I'm pro-choice, and we have Planned Parenthood here, and they are an organization that I believe in, and I don't believe in their organization, so, you know, it is a free country. If they want to come and pick it or whatever, they can do that.
Something like this can't go down without somebody's very specific vision. I think, you know, what Sarah's done is has created an environment that speaks to a whole. So, I mean, you have the Klan getting together here in Cleveland on Saturday, and you make your choices. It's a free country, and what you stand for is what you stand for, and it's sometimes it's obscene.
Come be with me. Come be with me. Come be with me.
I think it's really very difficult for an artist, male or female, to integrate activism into their life and their work. So that's the thing. What do we expect from our artists? At the same time, our artists create the symbolic language by which we understand our identities. And rock and roll, popular music, is all about identity and transforming your identity, and especially sexual and gender identity.
But if it's women and rock that you want to talk about, this seems like a step backwards, really. Because it's like, Okay, let's get all the girls together and we'll go off and cook. You know, instead of like mixing and being with your fellow musicians.
When is it we're going to get away from that? When are the Grammys going to be not the year of the woman and perhaps just be about music? Or when is anything not going to be about female and male rock? Everything is defined.
Best part to waking up is when I'm breaking up to stay. Reality never lives up to all that a dream could be.
It brings up the question of what it is and what do I feel it is to be a woman, and well, it ain't fucking incense and candles, right? And it ain't that big mural with some bird with a fucking harp, you know what I mean? It's about something else.
I mean, will somebody please just give me an old-fashioned, sweaty, big-titty bitch of rock and roll? Give me Joan Jett with a shag haircut and a black eye. Give me Pat Benatar, we do belong to the night. Give me Alana Miles, Black Velvet, if you please. For Christ's sake, give me Anne and Nancy Wilson.
I think the goal is for music to be an equal playing field where women and men aren't considered separate musical entities like a guitar and a bass, you know, or a flute and a drum. I mean, they're not exclusive of each other. The goal is for women to be included within the mainstream, treated as musicians, not treated as a novelty. And then I think she will have accomplished what she's accomplished.
Pull these guys out of here. It looks like it's gonna get bigger.
A hell of a lot bigger.
I just wanted to ask Sheryl, I mean, do you have a new perspective on Lilith Phair now coming off of what transpired at Woodstock?
Yeah, I've said on a couple of occasions that the day I got back, I ran to Sarah's arms, sobbed into the bosom of the founder of Lilith. It really, I mean, that was so shocking for me because even Woodstock in 1995 wasn't nearly that violent or sort of full of rage. I mean, what can I say? For me, it was a despicable, discouraging experience.
I think we're seeing right now a resurgence of a very male-oriented rock that has absolutely nothing to do with what's going on here today. At the same time, I think, hey, it's not that great if five women are being raped at Woodstock, if bands are at the top of the charts who are virulently anti-women, then I think that we have a long way to go
because they have inferiority complexes.
It feels so good to be touched by a man without his intentions, just to get what he can, and sometimes the vibe's right, but that chance is slight. A man's gotta see my every shade, not just spotlights, not just the nipple on my sweet tits supple. I hate it when a man only wants to suckle, because I am not your mama and I don't have milk, and besides I got a whole body covered in silk.
I feel a bit overwhelmed. There's a different energy. Like, I feel like I don't exist here. I'm just here observing.
Oh, no, I love women. I'm not threatened by women at all. I grew up, I have sisters and...
So tell us, what does Lilith Phair mean to you?
Lilith Phair, it means a really cool tour to work on. It's all that woman thing. Usually you don't have the opportunity to work with so many women artists. And on this tour, well, there's a lot of women technician with that. It's more fun than having just male, for example. Just make another, give more color to the tour.
I am the Lilith Fairy, F-A-I-R, with a Y. I have wings. I'm so happy to be here.
Today was the day of the most astrologically powerful solar eclipse.
Sir McLachlan thanked me personally for being in the second row and dancing the entire time.
Down. But you know I tried so hard to love you in my way. It's easy letting go.
I mean, who wants to spend every summer of their life doing something like this?
Just like the total stress out here. Yeah, it's incredible to live under. I've never been so like mistreated by a bunch of people. The pay is like absolutely horrible. None of the artists are very nice. It's really difficult, man. It's like...
But I don't know, I could do without most of these people, actually. See what I mean?
You know, everybody feels this way sometimes. Yeah, everybody feels this way. And I do. You can't hear it, but I do. And you can't hear it, but I'm feeling this way. Just because you say.
Nice and relaxed. Tell you it's the best tour you could be on. None of that back rock and roll, you know, none of that stuff.
Anyway, I'm Peter Stroud. Hiding behind the glasses because it's 7 weeks into this tour, so I'm sort of getting that bleary-eyed look probably.
I'm just a guitar player here at Lilith Fair, and so since I don't have anything to say, I thought that maybe I'd just kind of play the guitar. So here you go, here's a little guitar song.
Hold on to yourself. This is gonna hurt real bad.
There's a story of an actor who had died while he was drinking. It was no one I had heard of. And I'm turning to the horoscope and looking for the funnies. When I'm feeling someone watching me, and so I raise my head.
Thank you. The only pair of see-through nude panties that I have to wear in my dress will not hold my pack. Now, I try to devise a way to actually hold the pack between my buttocks. But you see, I'm not far left in yoga yet to be able to master that. And so there I am.
I'm going to go in and work on some experience.
First name basis.
Talked to each other on the phone a couple months ago, actually.
Beth.
Hello.
Any words for us?
Peace, love, and harmony. And transcendental excavation. Thank you for a lovely time. And have you got another blue pass? Because none of my mates could get it from backstage.
I'm marking a certain access. Each one gives it a certain limited access. Is this one's going to let people go anywhere they want except backstage?
Avert your eyes. Do not look directly in the artist's eyes.
No breaks.
You've never seen it before. It's better than ever.
First off, famous old quote there, what goes on the road stays on the road. That's when we all had our hair down past our waist and spiked belts, and I think things have changed a whole lot in many respects. The musicians have become a whole lot more skilled. The promiscuity and the sex, crazy drugs, rock and roll and all that is something of the past for most of us.
Canada tonight, and I had these immigration papers. Last time I went into Canada, they strip searched me because of prior criminal activity they say I have in the States. It was just like a disorderly conduct bullshit charge. But I had these papers inside my suitcase here, and they were in there for about a month, and the prints transferred onto the plastic. You gotta sand it off, because if they search my suitcase, they're gonna see that. The maple leaf is the toughest part to get off. Yeah, fucking immigration.
And of course, as it was the Pretenders' last show tonight, which is very sad for us because they're fantastic. Chrissie has been kind of trying to get me in trouble the whole time she's been on this tour. So I thought I'd give her a little of her own medicine back.
You see the darndest things.
Lights back, I drive it round in jeeps through the city, wearing big diamond rings and silk suits. Or past corrugated tin shacks full up with kids, and man, I don't mean a hamster nursery. But when you own a big chunk of the blood of third world, the babies just come at the scenery. Oh, come on, baby. Get the road. Yeah! All right, Sarah, do your dirty dancing. Girls, give it to them. There's no private calls. I can't get from the camp of the curse without some little trick on my back. Don't harass me, can't you tell? I'm going home, I'm tired of tell. I'm not the cat I used to be, I gotta get a 33, baby. Get in the road. Come on now. In the middle of the road, yeah. Oh Lord, have mercy.
We want to end off on a high note.
On a high note, too.
On a high note. We want to leave people wanting more.
It's an incredible and rewarding experience to put this whole thing on, but it's also a huge amount of work.
You know, we're going to take a break for it. Not going to close the door on it.
It doesn't mean we're closing the door on it.
You never know. In a couple of years, we might bring it back.
It's, will it ever come back? Don't know. You know, it's. I think a lot of that will be judged by what happens in the next six to 7 years. Not by what we do, but how everyone else reacts to its... his absence.
Unless Sarah wants to do it again, there is no Lilith Phair.
Could someone mount another Lilith Phair and call it Lilith Phair without Sarah? I think it would feel very not real. And we've talked about, is there somebody that could take the baton and run? I think she's so closely linked to it that it would be too difficult to do that. So I think that Sarah's a very big part of the world. Sure.
All the fear has left me now. I'm not frightened anymore. It's my heart that pounds beneath my flesh. It's my mouth that pushes out this breath. And if I shed a tear, I won't hate you. I won't fear love. And if I
if I feel a rage, I won't deny. I won't fear love. Pat into our demons, they will dance, and we will play. With chairs, candles, and cloth, making darkness in the day.
Entry in my diary. It's the last show of this tour. It's pouring rain outside, freezing cold. I've been sick for a week. I have partial laryngitis. I'm losing my voice. I really want to go home. I want this to be over, but I want to do a great job. It's very frustrating.
My kingdom is in ruins. Pouring rain.
I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried, and I spoke to remind you it was for those tears I died.
This question is for Sarah. In a few hours, you're going to be playing your final Lilith Fair concert. And I'm wondering if that has sunk in, and are you having any second thoughts?
No, not at all. I'm certainly savoring the moments, knowing this is the last show. I think everybody's going to do just fine.
I feel freaked out by it, just kind of nervous and excited and just kind of a little wired.
It'll be good to get back home, and it'll be sad to see the last of a lot of these folks that we've come to know so well.
I don't like to think about it. It's too bad. It really is too bad that it's over. I'm going to miss it a lot.
I mean, there's definitely a pretty heavy feeling overall. I mean, I've already seen people crying and stuff.
It gets emotional. I was sitting there, and Jamie starts blubbering. Our chef, I'm like, man, don't do that now. Like, at least wait till later on. I can't start now.
I don't believe this is your final year. That sucks. I could be doing this every single summer.
But in 5 years, she's going to come back and have, like, a reunion. That's
definitely
what she's
going to do. Reunion Lilith Fair.
Reunion.
Shoot.
I'll be there front row right there.
Oh, yeah. We'll get up on stage and sing with you.
Yeah.
I wish we could go away for a week and sleep in my bed and then come back and do it again for a while. I'm ready not to build a stage ever again.
I'm so ready. But the mill's closing down. It's going to be Flint, Michigan, in the Lilith camp. All over.
There you are.
Hi.
How's your day on
camera?
It was good.
How was yours? How are you feeling?
Same.
Sorry, bum?
Hold. Yeah, kind of. I've already cried twice.
Oh, have you?
People keep hugging me and start crying. It's like,
I know. I got out of conversation with you. I was like, don't even do it.
Stop it.
When I don't, can I stay? Are you strong enough to be my man?
Stone magazine's not even here, you know what I mean?
Right.
Or Spin. It's like
nobody really.
You know what? They should have done a cover story on this festival this year. And not like a little blurb on the side of the on the sidebar. I mean, like, they should have done a cover story with like a group picture. Whatever. It's better that they're not here.
Yeah, really. I mean, for everybody.
You're here.
I still have to offer the same to live. But nobody gets a lifetime rehearsal as specks of dust will universal. To let this love survive be the greatest gift that we could give. And tell all the friends who think they're so together. All these thoughts of fairer weather. And though it's storming out, I feel safe within the arms of love's discovery.
So, a question for Sam.
I wonder if you're getting a little more sentimental as you get to the close of the
story. Have you accomplished what you hoped to at the start of the
biggest thing? Change can you point to that you feel like Lilith Phair has made?
Sarah, are you more comfortable with the amount of attention that you personally received?
What impact do you think Lilith Phair has had on the music industry?
What's the greatest life lesson you learned after being involved for Lilith Phair?
Where is this name going to go next? I know you're saying what since being a part of Lilith Phair.
But still can't wait. Can you imagine a 30th anniversary of Lilith Phair?
How do you want people to remember the Lilith Phair?
Everything can be replaced, and every distance is not near. So I remember every face of every man who put me here.
I see my life.
Why you set this in motion was you wanted to prove to the industry that it can be done. Do you think you've already done that before the first note has been struck?
Well, I definitely think there's a great energy surrounding the beginning of this tour, and
I think a lot of the success for me lies in just getting all these artists together. And whatever happens from here is just going to be an added bonus. It's going to be a big positive.
Lend me a beat.